Green fight, green fast, catch gloves. Corner.
Yuji Shimada, our referee for this one. Three rounds of action between the three-time Pakistani submission grappling champion, Muhammad Imran. And
you
the
ready?
One Indonesian featherweight tournament
go.
Champion, undefeated Stefer Rahardian. Rahardian has some powerful hands. Could he score the GoDaddy knockout of the night on Muhammad Imran? Imran in southpaw stance. Got some range on him, the Pakistani, but he'll want to get Rahardian down. And there's a sample of the power in the right hand of the Indonesian Rahardian.
That's what he says he's been working on. He's got a nice trip hammer over a right hand. It's coming right down the middle. But Imran's got one too. You can see that left hand is cocked and loaded and ready to let go.
Looks for the outside leg kick to Rahardian. Goes for the inside leg and Imran saw it coming. Inside leg kick from the Pakistani. Rahardian edges forward. Oh, jab two, smack back in the and Imran does a quick count of his teeth. Inside leg kick from Imran.
I like the adjustment that he made. He landed that right hand. His chin was a little bit up in the air. Imran was able to counter and catch that chin up. But you could see Rahardian immediately chuck that chin under, listening to his corner to keep that chin nice and tucked.
It's a kickboxing contest so far. 3 minutes 40 remaining. Good sticking left hand there from Muhammad Imran. Goes for the inside leg. Rahardian moves the leg out of the way. He fires a scraping right hand. There's that left down the tube again from Imran. As you said, Mitch, it carries some power from the Pakistani.
It does. If you time it correctly, when Stefer Rahardian has his chin up, he can connect and do some damage. But you can just see consistently that Stefer Rahardian is adjusting to keep his chin nice and tucked.
Again, Muhammad Imran throwing that left hand like Jose Macron used to bowl past the Pakistani. And now we're on the ground for the very first time. Rahardian top position. One butterfly hook there for Muhammad Imran.
Imran's got over control on one side. He's trying to posture, he's trying to create some movement. He's got the butterfly hook on the left side. Let's see if he can create a little bit of action, create a little bit of sweep here. Rahardian keeping the hips nice and tight to him.
Locking up that left arm of Rahardian, quite wisely so, Muhammad Imran. Does not want Rahardian to posture up, break this guard and land the ground and pound. That's what Rahardian's trying to do, trying to yank that left arm out.
You can see he's got two overhooks to keep the arms in position. Might be setting up an arm bar, might be thinking about swiveling the hips to the side and throwing up that arm bar. He's known for that.
Rahardian's still trying to take that left arm out. You see occasionally Imran will glance towards his corner. He's receiving all sorts of instructions. And still the close guard here from Muhammad Imran.
Imran's doing a good job avoiding damage. See how he's tying up the arms and see how he's blocking right there? Those are three punches that did not get through. Very good defense from Imran from the bottom. And he's able to turn around. Now he's got a little bit more space to move. He's got an active guard who likes to throw up arm bars and triangles. And if he's not pressed up against the cage, he's going to have more ability to throw those up.
This crowd, this sellout crowd in Jakarta, are trying to roll the ground and pound from Stefer Rahardian.
Not a lot of those are connecting though, Michael. Imran's moving quite well. He hasn't really taken damage. He's actually throwing those short little elbows and connecting.
Pops up with the elbow again. That one with the elbows in.
Trade elbows there, both of them connected.
Still the close guard of Imran. Very low close guard, however. And now he heightens it. Got to control the posture of Rahardian. Locks down the Indonesian's left arm. Pulls down his chest to hit.
See, this is the beauty of our scoring. At one championship, we don't just necessarily give the person on top that is going to have the advantage. You can see that Imran is being very active off of his back. He's able to negate a lot of the strikes coming at him and throw strikes of his own.
Rahardian momentarily postured up, goes to the body, then to the head off the left hand. Indonesian now raining down the punches from inside the Pakistani's guard.
A lot of those shots are connecting. He postures up, he's able to have a little bit more leverage. Imran's not able to reach him, but Rahardian can touch his face up.
It's gonna go to the second round of action. A tremendous way to finish the round for Stefer Rahardian.
Here we can see that nice little right hand there. He parried with the left, came in with the straight right hand. Well done on the feet. You can see the improvements that Rahardian has made, but there he got caught with, you know, a left hand from Muhammad Imran. Here's that takedown, and that's what we saw the majority of the round. Rahardian on top, but I gotta say, I was very impressed with the guard and the defense of Muhammad Imran in that round.
Muhammad Imran really is a big deal in Pakistan. There aren't many martial arts superstars in Pakistan, but you better believe Muhammad Imran is one of them. Stefer Rahardian comes in undefeated. Can he keep the streak alive in front of a sellout crowd inside the Jakarta Convention Center? Wherever you're watching, in over 128 countries around the world, we hope you're enjoying the first one championship event of 2018. Set to be our biggest yet.
Go!
Imran wants to touch gloves. Rahardian obliges. A crowd rally for Stefer Rahardian. He's known for his firework finishes, Rahardian. Can he pull another one out tonight? Inside leg kick from Muhammad Imran. High kick from Rahardian. Double forearms caught it from the Pakistani. Looks for the inside leg again. And his one way to slow down the boxing of Rahardian is to kick his legs. A good punch starts from the feet and travels up the legs, through the bodies, down the arms, into the fist. So it goes without saying, if you can slow down the legs, they can't box effectively.
I'm not seeing this, I'm not seeing angles cut by either one of them. They're kind of keeping their front legs in the position. If one of them steps off to the side, that straight rear punch is gonna be a much more effective. But a nice double leg takedown again from Rahardian.
Rahardian trying to move and pass guard right in front of our commentary position. He's gone to half guard now. Good position for the Indonesian.
He's got the underhook on this side. This is a very dominant position in half guard. You can see he's got the underhook on that left side because Muhammad Imran's going to want to get that underhook with his right arm, get underneath the arm of Rahardian and start to move his hips out to the side. As long as Rahardian can keep his back flat against the mat like that, he's gonna have much better control.
You can see Imran locking up the leg here of Stefer Rahardian, trying to put him back in the full guard. Rahardian won't go there. Cracks away with the right hand. Ties up the left hand of Rahardian. Now the Indonesian may try and get it free.
You can see the lockdown position that's preventing the way that he has triangled his legs around Muhammad Imran's, or Muhammad Imran, he had it before, but now he's just keeping the half guard. But he's got a very good half guard, and he's able to control this position quite well, but you can see that he's got to try to turn onto his side. He has to create a little bit of movement because Rahardian is keeping him flat on his back. See, he has the underhook there with his left arm, and he's able to keep him pressure right there. Look at him, always being active, and that's preventing Yuji Shimada from standing him up.
What impresses me is Rahardian is doing exactly what he said he'd do yesterday. He said, I want to keep a consistent pace, and he is constantly working here against Muhammad Imran. It's non-stop from the Indonesian Rahardian.
He's softened up with the ground and pound, consistently punching, consistently trying to advance his position. He's trying to get that leg out. You can see Imran's trying to frame off the hips, create a little bit of space, but Rahardian's having none of it.
If you're in the corner of Muhammad Imran, what are you telling the Pakistani to do here, man?
He's got to get the underhook on that right side. With his right arm, he has to get underneath the arm of Rahardian and create a little bit of space, turn onto his left side and start pushing away, create those scrambles. But as long as Rahardian has his arm underneath on the left side, he's able to just pick him apart the mat.
Oh, Rahardian measures him with these elbows. And the ground and pound again. Muhammad Imran nowhere to go. Another fantastic showing here from Stefer Rahardian. Inside of half guard, that left leg locked up by the Pakistani.
That was too good. This guy has both underhooks on the side. He couldn't start moving. But Rahardian's using that elbow to push against the chin. Keep him there.
For Rahardian. They're saying finish him, finish him. They want to see the dynamite. They want to see the fireworks that Rahardian is renowned for.
He might get past that. Pretty good by Muhammad Imran.
And Rahardian straight back on him, Mitch.
I know you're very impressed with the ground and pound, and the fans are as well, but Muhammad Imran is not letting the fans or the shots get the better of him. And he's able to keep him in the half guard position. Rahardian was laying punches down on him, and Muhammad Imran kept the half guard, maintained position, and or maybe Rahardian just comfortable staying there beating on him.
The question is though, Mitch, can Imran turn this defense into any sort of offense?
He can if he creates a little bit of movement, but Rahardian's just a step above him in the grappling game. And he's adding in shots over and over again. We got 10 seconds left. We're gonna see a third round, but I'm still impressed with Muhammad Imran, but Rahardian is putting it on him.
That was dominance from Stefer Rahardian. We're going to go into the third round. Rahardian ending the second on top in control, Mitch.
Beautiful double leg takedown. And that was just the story of this round. We can just see Stefer Rahardian turns up the pace, shifts into a higher gear, and starts letting his ground and pound go. Just landing the short elbows, picking Muhammad Imran apart. But the durability and the toughness of the Pakistani martial artist is on display while we're just seeing a grappling clinic put on by the Indonesian Stefer Rahardian.
Some damage around the face there of Muhammad Imran, courtesy of the ground and pound from Rahardian. And we are ready to rock and roll, third and final round of our co-main event inside the sold-out Jakarta Convention Center in Indonesia. The cage door is locked.
Final round! Final round!
Rahardian gives fans what they want and find a finish. Southpaw again from Imran, comes out jabbing with the right hand. The Pakistani's got to find a way to turn the tide. Defensively, he's looked good, but he needs to go on the offense now. Rahardian edges forward, resets himself. Looking very composed, the Indonesian. There's the right hand, just glances the beard of Imran. Don't forget, we do score as an overall contest here at One Championship, not round by round.
The contest has gone to Stefer Rahardian so far at this point, as we only have 4 minutes left. But if Muhammad Imran can keep this on his feet, touch up Rahardian, do some damage, drop him, maybe he can shift the tide in his favor.
In his grappling career as a three-time national Pakistani champion, Muhammad Imran was known for pulling submissions seemingly out of nowhere. Almost like a magician pulling a rabbit out of the hat. Can he find the rabbit? Can he find the hat here against Rahardian?
It's possible. This is martial arts and anything is possible. But Rahardian seems to be picking up hard here on his feet. He's landing with that right hand over and over again. And you can start to see some of the welts developing on the forehead. I think that's from the elbows earlier, from the ground and pound from Rahardian.
There's the right hand again from Rahardian. It's got some mustard behind it. Left cross from Muhammad Imran. And Rahardian backs him up with another solid right hand. They're juking it out toe-to-toe now. Both men throwing their heavy salvos.
I think a double leg takedown from Rahardian is going to be coming real soon, because Muhammad Imran is starting to touch him up in the stand-up.
misses with the inside leg kick.
Push him back! Push him back!
Imran has to know that time is ticking down for him.
Three big shots, they both connected.
Haven't seen them go to ground in this round. We have plenty in the previous two.
We can see that the, like the grappling, there's just too, they're just too many levels apart.
Half time, half time.
They're actually pretty even. They're trading shots.
Rib kick there from Muhammad Imran off the back leg. That being the power leg of the southpaw. And we always say it, but what Rahardian wants to do against the southpaw is engage the right hand. Put his lead foot on the outside of Imran's lead foot and throw the right hand all night long.
You can see that. He's starting to step out to the side, but there's that double leg takedown. As Imran was starting to land shots, Rahardian didn't want any more of it. Let's take it back down to the ground where we're safe, where we're confident, where we're doing
rest.
Most of the damage, and that's exactly what he does.
1 minute and 45 seconds for Muhammad Imran of Pakistan to try and find something special against Indonesia's Stefer Rahardian.
The entire match, we haven't seen Rahardian advance in the side control or mount because of this half guard position. You can see he has a lockdown where he has kind of the legs of Rahardian a little bit tied up, not quite a lockdown, but at least he has a really good grip on it there. And he's able to hold Rahardian in that position. In that same aspect, he's holding him in a position where Rahardian's able to drop some serious elbows.
This really is a tremendous performance from Stefer Rahardian against an opponent of the highest order. There will be no easy contest going forward for Stefer Rahardian. He is taking the leap to the next level here in ONE Championship. And how Jakarta and all of Indonesia has embraced him. Inside the half guard, 45 seconds to go, Mitch.
Back in January, we saw the same thing when Rahardian went up against Jerome Pei. Back in April, we saw the same thing when he went up against Eugene Tocaro, just outworking his opponents, dropping the ground and pound, softening him up, just continually doing damage.
The crowd rally again, they ride to the occasion as those elbows drop down from Rahardian. For the shooting star of Indonesia.
Stefer Rahardian put on a grappling clinic. Very impressive. Here he is going in, engaging in the stand-up, landing with that nice right hand over and over again, winning a lot of the stand-up exchanges. But once he sends the timings right, he slides in, gets the takedown, and really just dominates the match from that point. Him landing elbows, ground and pound in the half guard. Didn't even really try to pass into more dominant positions, but just stayed comfortable right in that half guard position and beat up Muhammad Imran. But the toughness and durability of Muhammad Imran from Pakistan was on display here tonight.
Rahardian did everything he said he would do. He said he wouldn't rush. He said he worked on his striking. He said he'd keep a consistent pace and take his time, and he did just that.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of intense battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Stefer Rahardian!
Stefer Rahardian, still undefeated, the Indonesian rising star.